So now we will do the next problem for checking the validity of a given argument. So here are some sentences which we are denoting them by PQRST. So first is, it is sunny this afternoon, that is P. Q is that it is colder than yesterday. R is that we will go swimming. S is we will take a canoe trip. And T is we will be home by sunset. So now the argument starts. The first statement of argument is that it is not sunny. It is not sunny means negation P. This afternoon and colder than yesterday. And colder than yesterday is denoted by Q. The second thing is we will go swimming. So what is we will go swimming? Only if it is sunny. Means swimming implies sunny. So swimming is R. Implies. Sunny is denoted by P. The third argument statement in the argument is if we do not go swimming means negation R, then we will take a canoe trip. We will take a canoe trip is S. The last statement is if we take a canoe trip means S implies then we will be home by sunset. S implies T. And what are we expecting? The conclusion of this particular argument. It is we will be home by sunset. We will be home by sunset is denoted by T. So we will check whether this particular argument is a valid argument or not. So let us start simplifying these things. Now it is very clear that when I look at the third and the fourth, negation R implies S and S implies T. So I can here use hypothetical syllogism, which will clearly say that negation R implies T. So these two arguments I'm going to keep as it is. P and Q. R implies P. And here I will get negation R implies T. Okay. Now I know that there is a R here also and there is a negation R here also. So I will try to convert this into contrapositive. So what will I get? Negation P and Q. R implies P. And here I am going to get negation T implies R. So here now if we look at these two statements, what is happening? Negation T is implying R and R is implying P. So again by hypothetical syllogism, what can I say? Negation T implies negation P. Let me repeat. Negation T is becoming R and R is becoming P. This means that negation T will become P. And this statement is as it is, negation P and Q. Now here in this argument, what you see is that this negation P and Q can be simplified to only negation P. This is your simplification. I really don't need Q here, which is negation P. The second statement I can write the contrapositive of that. The contrapositive of this particular statement will be negation P implies negation of negation T will be P. So I am getting, I have reduced to negation P and negation P implies T. Now I can apply modus ponens. And what does modus ponens give us? It will give us T. And this is what we were expecting. So we have got the conclusion, negation T, and this means that this particular argument is a valid argument. So this ends the problem here.